The Months Below, Nightfall, by Greenback, read by Deathlight, Chapter 1, Return to Darkness. The road to hell is paved with good intentions. Traditional preverb. There are days in our lives that we long for. Days when we finally get opportunities we've waited for. When dreams, sometimes decades in the making, finally come true. I've worked towards my days more years than I can count. From Salamanca to Manhattan to Canterlot and beyond. I've guided the unwary as my pawns. Worked to manipulate things from behind the scenes. And set all the pieces in motion to finally reach the finish line. And now, the time has finally come. This is the day when all my dreams come true. The fireplace glows as the logs burn brightly, giving my parents' house a delightful warmth. It is the perfect counter to the storm raging outside, which has gotten slightly worse over the past few hours. Even with the thick walls, I can hear the rain pounding the grass, and the trees creaking as they're buffeted by the wind. I'm content to sit here for a minute and enjoy my drink, till the crackle of the fire and the pound of the rain wash all the doubt from my soul. It's a feeling of utter peace and tranquility, one that I rarely felt. The grandfather clock dings. At this late hour, no one would pay me a visit, and with the storm coming in, even less so. It'd be foolish to go out in that tempest, and for that reason, I'm effectively isolated. It was exactly what I wanted. With a sip, I finish my drink and savor the flavor as it goes down my throat. I'm ready. I changed my proper attire, having packed all my gear hours ago. It's a quick matter to slip into my saddlebags and strap them down. The last time I did this, I was unprepared. But now I carry extra flares, ropes, and shoulder-mounted lanterns with enough light to last for hours. But I won't need that much time. I know exactly where I'm going and what I'm looking for. By this time tomorrow, I finally see my dreams resolved. I descended into the basement. The darkness holds no terrors for me now, as I follow the path I took all those years ago. Perfect study, and the tunnels are exactly as I remember them. So too is the door. It's still sealed tight, only now with extra locks, latches, and chains holding it shut. The insignias of the Rose Sisters lie upon them, a warning that the door should only be opened by them alone. I tear the locks away, yank the chains free, and swivel the door open. Old memories wash over me, and for a moment I tense up, expecting an arm to reach out and grab me. Nothing happens. I shine my light inside the tunnel and see nothing but a long, curved hallway. There's nothing inside. I'm alone. Good. I walked these paths long ago when I was pursuing my dream of becoming an alicorn. In these dark passages, I found the horn of the cursed king, a ruler from long ago. And though the horn gave me great power, it was taken from me. It was only through my long struggles and searches that I learned where it was sent. The princesses had taken the horn back to its original resting place. And sealed the tunnel for good, so no one else could ever find it. It was a good plan, with only one problem. They underestimated how much I wanted it. It takes me an hour to descend the switchback, string a portable ladder, and climb down into the massive rotunda. Cracking a flare, I found the shredded remains of my old rope, untouched by the passes of time. There's no need to worry about the thing that caught it. The creature is long gone, eliminated by Princess Luna. Her courage and determination have cleared my path. I have nothing to fear down here. It's cold as I head to the chamber within the tunnels. I head down the same one I took so many years ago. Once it gets too steep, I tie a rope and use it to lower myself even further, grinning all the while. No slipping this time. I reach the hole and extend a portable ladder into the water below. Opening my bags, I attach the diving gear to my harness and enter the water. It still lies cold, no doubt fed from the melting snow that trickles down from the peaks of the mountains. It's of no concern, my wetsuit helps keep the cold at bay and even warms it after a while. Flipping my mask down and ensuring that the flow of air through the respirator is unobscured, I slip beneath the surface and swim into the pits, looking for the... there it is. The hole, still as small as before, forcing me to take off my air tanks and push them ahead to squeeze inside. While I'm not afraid of entering this labyrinth once again, this is the part that makes me nervous. In the very faint chance of something happening, I'll be trapped, unable to get out of here quickly. I try to keep calm, my breaths coming faster as the walls scrape against neoprene. The tunnel slopes upwards, I follow it, a grin forming around my mouthpiece. Breaking the surface of the water, I waste no time in taking off the tanks and cracking a flare. The green light illuminating the tomb of the cursed king. I check my watch and find it only took me 2.5 hours to get here. With all the lights in my saddlebags, I could have spent hours exploring and examining the place if I wanted to. But I'm not an archaeologist here to examine priceless relics or treasures. I've come to take what's mine. I check the ceiling. Yes, that's the small groove where I first found it. And surprise, surprise, it's empty. But where did the princesses hide it? I know where it is, call it a sixth sense, but I can sense its presence. I shine the flare upon the giant cube at the back. It hasn't changed since I was last here. There isn't even any dust on its surface. At least, not to the naked eye. But something about it seems different. Like there's an aura I can only faintly detect. I go to the front of the cube and to the holes where I've allowed the captor to peer out. They're just wide enough to slice something inside. I gulp. The last time I was here, I never brought a light up to see what's down those holes. I was in too much of a hurry, but in retrospect, I'm glad I didn't. If I had seen a pair of eyes glaring back at me, I might have lost my mind. But if the princesses came here, surely they would not allow the cursed king to remain alive within the cube, would they? They would have released him, or at least put him out of his misery after countless years of insanity, wouldn't they? Grab my flare, I raise it up to the holes so that the light shines inside. 1, 2, 3. I peer inside. The holes stretch far back into the cube. But there are no eyes staring back at me, nor are there any hollow sockets of a skull. In fact, I can see into the cramped interior of the cube itself. There it is, at the bottom of the cube. An all too familiar horn. Grabbing a bottle from my saddlebags, I undo the cap and toss the liquid inside all over the cube. If the merchant was telling me the truth, then I should... yes. Luck is on my side as a sliver appears in the cube, dividing it in two, that perhaps silently floats upwards, revealing a strangely shaped hollow within the black obsidian. I can't tell what's for, and I don't care. All that matters is the horn lying within. The horn is warm as I pick it up. It almost seems to hum, pulsing with power, recognizing the one who last wielded it. Hello again, my old friend. I watch the horn for a few minutes. So much effort, fear, doubt, and anticipation spent on such a little thing. I have to stroke it to ensure to myself that it's real, but it is, and it's mine. Grinning, I slapped the horn inside of my saddlebags before cracking a new flare, putting my diving gear back on and swimming through the tunnel and back into the pits, and began my ascent back to the surface. Logically, I should conserve my energy, but I didn't care. After everything I've been through, my horn is back with me once more. My parents tried to stop me, and they failed. Beatbreaker tried to stop me, and she failed. Even the princesses failed. I've got the horn, and nobody's going to stop me this time. I tear up the ladder and into the tunnel, getting rope burns as I yank myself through. When the slope levels out, I'm able to gallop until I reach the cavern, and then the chamber. My rope ladder is still intact, and I waste no time in scrambling up. As my flare dies, I light a new one. Pleased to see that I have plenty more in my saddlebags. I'm not going to be running blind this time. I take my time heading up the switchbacks, stopping whatever my legs needed to break. I even take a moment to sit for my canteen. Spelunking is hard work after all, and I need to stay hydrated. Once I reach the top, I trot down the last tunnel. The door is ahead, then the basement and the house. I'm almost home free. Okay, I need to think. Yes, it's great to have the horn back, but I still need to have a plan. I'll come up with something more fleshed out tomorrow. But let's see, I'll use the surgical unit to attach the horn. Then sneak into Medicomp and get the wings. With the magic on my side, getting through security will be easy. Not even the new system the CEO put in will be able to stop me. Maybe I could try casting a sleeping spell on the entire building. Yes, that could work. With everyone deep in dreamland, I'll be free to go wherever I want. Wait, that might not work. What if Luna finds everyone asleep and recognizes something's going on? I ought to think about this a little more. Oh well, it can wait. For now, I can celebrate. Once I get out of here, a nice, big dinner is in order, with extra servings of ice cream. Getting the horn back calls for a celebration, and I've got just the... wait. No, I'm disoriented. Yeah, that's it. My mind's playing tricks on me, because the door can't have closed on its own. That's what it looks like, but no, it can't be. I'll just go up to it, slip right through, and laugh at how I hallucinated at the very end. Perhaps the result of my subconscious trying to make me feel guilty or something. Wait, if it's a hallucination, why is it still closed? I knock, and... Oh no! The door's closed! But how? It couldn't have. Someone would have had to close it from the other side. I grab and tug, but no, it won't move. It's stuck. Buck! Okay, calm down. Calm down, Silverspeak. You can get through this. So the door shuts. If the door can be closed, it can be opened. You just need to find a way to do that. Yes, the silver pellet is gone, but you'll find something else. A weak spot, maybe. And if there isn't, you'll just have to wait until the foreman gets down here in a day or two to seal up the place and be grateful. Tell them they have no memory of coming here. That you must have sleepwalked into the house. Yeah, that's it. Hide the horn in my wetsuit, waltz on out, and nobody will be the wiser. Deep breaths, keep taking deep breaths, that'll help me calm down. A padded mind is a dead mind, just take a few minutes to relax before looking for a way out. I step away from the door and lean against the wall, and freeze. The door is covered in scratch marks. My heart skips a beat as I get closer. Yes, I remember when I slammed the door shut. I heard the creature clawing away from the other side. These claw marks are huge. Whatever made them must have been big, even bigger than I originally... wait. What was that? I turn and look down the tunnel. There's nothing there. Strange. I could have sworn I heard something move. I slap myself. My mind's playing tricks on me. There's nothing down here. It's just... wait. There it is again. Movements. Okay, don't panic. It's just falling rocks, that's all. A stalactite collapsing in the distance. Nothing to be afraid of. I toss the flare as hard as I can and watch it as it rolls down the tunnel before it comes to a stop. Nothing moves. I crack another flare, need to be ready just in case. The tunnel goes dark. What? No, that's impossible. The flare wasn't old. These are newer models, longer lasting. I toss the newest one down the tunnel. It lands, rolls, and comes to a stop. Okay, just as defective. The flare vanishes. Then I hear it, scraping sounds further down the tunnel. No, it can't be, it can't be! Something's coming towards me. I yank out another flare and try to crack it. That won't come on. Why won't it come on? I try another. It refuses to start. I try the glow sticks. They crack, but no light comes from them. I hear claws hitting stone. This can't be happening. No, this isn't real. It's not real. That thing is dead. Dead! You're not real! You're not real! You're dead! Do you hear me? You're dead! My back against the door, my heart trying to break its way out of my chest. This can't be real. It can't be real. It can't. Breathing, loud, ragged breathing. No! Oh, Celestia! I need to get out! I gotta get out! There has to be a way to open this door! I grab it, try to find a hoof hold, a crack, anything, but there's nothing. I'm panting so hard, my lungs feel like they're about to burst. Nothing happens. I turn to the darkness, trying to see something, anything. There's nothing. A hallucination, that's all. Something the breathing makes of my air tanks. It's messing my brain and making me see things. I just need to relax, to wait it out. Let it seep from my system. It's all in my head. Grabbing the wall, I sit down. Cold, bony fingers grab my legs. Something giggles. I scream. Wait, what happened? I'm lying on something. Am I dead? No, I'm not dead. I'm still breathing. I must have fainted, or I woke up. Yes, that's it. I woke up. It was all a nightmare, a horrible nightmare. But it's all over now. I just need to get something to calm my nerves. Wait, the ceiling. This isn't my room. This is the tomb of the cursed king. The flickering light of my old flare just gives me enough illumination to see the walls. How did I get here? Did I bump my head trying to get out with a horn? I've got to... wait, why can't I move? I struggle, but I can't move my legs. It's like they're tied together. I roll, and the light of the flare reveals I'm completely wrapped up in what looks like spider silk. But how? When did... Bony fingers grab hold of my wrappings. Oh no, oh Celestia, no! I struggle for all I'm worth, trying to cry out. But this wrapping has glued my mouth shut. I can't even yell as I'm carried towards, oh no, please not that, anything but that! My captor pushes me into the cube, and I finally learn the truth behind the hollowed out space. It's curved to fit a pony, nestling them like a glove. And now it grabs hold as I'm inserted into it. Until only my spine and head remains exposed. It's a perfect fit. I struggle, trying to lift myself out. I've got to get out of here before... The top of the cube descends into place. And press so tightly against me that I can barely breathe. Oh Celestia, it's sealing me in! It's sealing me in! I try to move, to squirm, anything. I suddenly yell at my body to move, but it can't obey me. They keep forcing me to remain still, denying any attempts at movement. All I can move are my eyes, and all I can see are the hole showing me the ceiling where the horn is kept. But there's nothing there now, only the shadow of something walking away from the cube. The light from the flare sputters. No! Darkness fills the chamber. There's a chuckle, a splash, and all is silent. No! With a final flicker, the light dies and everything goes dark. No! Nobody knows I'm here. Nobody would dare come to look. In a few days, the tunnel will be sealed. The basement filled, and the passages in and out of the labyrinth beneath the mountain will be forever lost. So that no one may ever again be tempted to come down and search for the relic that should be forgotten. But I'll be here, I'll be alive, unable to escape, to scream, to do anything but lie within the cube, lost, forgotten, and trapped. Forever. I scream, the sound silenced before I can even get out. But I still try, I scream again, and again, and again, and again. I scream, but this time I hear it. I stop my eyes open, light hits my eyes. Lights? But how? I try to get up, but my head is stone. I scream again. Wait, I can move. I can see my limbs. The shackles and chains are there, but I can move. I'm not webbed up, my jumpsuit is still here, the orange, barely visible, and the glow from the crystal inside my cell. I'm a nightmare, another nightmare. But on the tunnels beneath Sadalanka, I'm in my cell. I collapse back against my thin blanket. Now soaked with sweat, just like the rest of me. Heart pounding, I look around the cell. There are no monsters here, no terrors waiting to spring forward as they do every night in my dreams. Only one set of eyes, me my own, but it's a gaze I'm so grateful for. Reaching out, I grab little Celestia and clutch her to me as tightly as I can. Her eyes looking up at me, her small smile reassuring me that everything's alright. But it wasn't alright. No matter how many times I endure them, these nightmares never get any easier. And they never go away. I squeeze my eyes shut, trying not to cry.